Warning, this is a very long video, but in this video, we're gonna install Ubuntu 18 Lite onto a Dell dual-core laptop. Today we're gonna install the latest version, the pre-release version of Ubuntu 18, and we're gonna do that on another Ubuntu laptop that is running Ubuntu 17. So we're gonna upgrade 17 to 18. I want to do a clean install. So what I'm gonna do is, in fact, I'm gonna make a backup of all the stuff that I have on my machine. I'm gonna show you how to do that. I'm gonna do that to a little external portable drive. So what's the deal? We first, of course, clean up and copy all these files that we want to keep to the portable drive. And then, in fact, we can kill the beats, okay? So what we're gonna do then is create a bootable USB stick to install, cause I mean, like burning a DVD is kinda useless if you also have them little USB sticks. I'm gonna use a little USB stick from 4 GB. So we're gonna then write the ISO to the USB stick so it will be bootable. And then in fact, you can boot it on any x86 device, meaning if you have an old laptop with some gigabytes of RAM, 2 GB or so, processor 1.6 Celeron will do just fine. Then you can boot and do the installation from that USB stick. We're gonna do the complete whole thing. So welcome to a new installing video here at Channel 48 with, of course, your host, Puck Darlington. Let's get started. Okay, my friends, here is the victim and here is the drive. It just opened the drive, and what I did, I created a folder that I called Linux Backup. So how are you gonna start backing up? Well, I think that the best thing to do is to open your home folder and then go to desktop and just select all the files that you want to copy. These are all pings and icons and ROMs, desktop apps. I see here lots of folders. In fact, we could say Control A and then just see what we can deselect. We should not see any parts of the system in here. So we can just do a Control A and then we just gonna copy that to the folder. So when this is copied, of course, we then gonna go to documents and we're gonna do the same with the documents. We select everything and then copy them to there. Okay, we go to downloads. Up here we also give it a little Control A and we copy it to the folder. We go to music, we have some music here. We go ahead and copy it to the folder. Pictures, only one folder with pictures, we copy it to the folder. And then videos, nothing. So that's it. So we selected all these files that we had in desktop. In Deltop we won't find anything. Probably I will find my icons. So I'm also gonna select the Control A in here and I'm just gonna scroll up and deselect some of the folders that should not be copied, like my music, my pictures, my downloads, my documents, my desktop. Those we don't have to copy. My videos, I see here. Templates we don't have to copy. And for the rest we could copy everything, so we're just gonna copy that to there. So as you can see, Linux is now busy with copying, and this will take a while because we have a whole lot of files to copy. This is 53 GB, 712 MB, 15 GB, 2.9 GB, 412 and 29.1 gigabytes. Oh, wait a minute. Yes. So we're just gonna let this go, and this might take a while. So when this is done, I will be back, and then we're gonna continue to the next step, and that will be the creation of course, the bootable USB stick. Now you might wonder, why Ubuntu? What's so good about Ubuntu? Well, let me tell you, my friends, Ubuntu is a very nice operating system because it's Linux. On the other hand, we're not gonna install any version of Ubuntu. The version that we're gonna install, my friends, this will be, of course, the Mate version. Because Mate will give us that experience and that power to change things around and make it completely our own. As if it's ours. So that's really nice. We will be able to change the boot animation, we will change the desktop and make it completely the way we want it to look. For instance, if we want it to look, for instance, like something that Windows 10 looks like, we could give it these looks. There are even guys out there creating all sorts of themes. I'm not gonna use any of that because I love to mod my systems myself. So my friends, the files are already copied, and now we're gonna create a bootable USB stick. What will you need? We're gonna create a bootable USB stick under Linux, and we're gonna use a tool called UNetBootin. Why UNetBootin? Well, because UNetBootin creates a decent USB bootable device that you can use to install Linux. Just like that. Sometimes we deal with computers that don't want to boot from a stick that we created with UNetBootin. Most of the times, these are the 64-bit versions. Those you can better burn or write to a USB stick, restore to a USB stick with Power ISO, because Power ISO will do it the right way. And if it does not work with UNetBootin, Power ISO will be the answer to fix your problem. Are you ready? Let's get started. Welcome back. Many hours has gone by. I had to back up at least 85 gigabytes. And it was kind of slow over the USB 2 port. So it was not that is fast. So I just went to bed, and today is a new day. And now we can continue our installing. Well, so we're gonna do it on a Dell. It's a dual core laptop, 64-bit. However, I decided to install the 32-bit version, as I already said, because the 32-bit version is just fine for devices with less than 4 gigabytes memory. Okay, so let's jump into the project and let's go do it. Okay guys, I did create a bootable USB stick with UNetBootin, but it's not booting. So I told you, alternative will be Power ISO, and yeah, I'm gonna do that on my Windows machine. So I have my Windows machine here, and I'm gonna boot up Power ISO, and you will boot Power ISO with administrator rights. So right mouse click, okay, and then run as administrator. You see that? It will ask for permission, and then you're gonna say yes. Simply go to tools here on top. You're gonna see tools, and then you select create bootable USB stick, and then you go get the Ubuntu. In my case, it's on my desktop. There it is. Select it. And then click start. Confirm. And then the USB stick will be created. So that's what I'm gonna do right now. Okay, there we are.
to open the laptop and we're gonna boot up from the USB stick. On this laptop you will need to hit F12 or so. Let me see, yeah, F12, and then you're gonna get into this boot menu. And of course we're gonna select USB because we created a bootable USB stick. So there we go, finally. Okay, there we go. Sometimes, yeah, you must explain it kind of good, eh? Because some people, not everybody know whatever we're doing here. Some people just don't know. And then they want to have that information. The only thing we can do is give it to them in a nice and decent way, so they kind of understand what's crack-a-lacking and what's going on. Okay, so this looks kind of good. It's booting up, and I'm gonna wipe everything that was on this machine. And I saw that Linux Mint was also at version 18, so we're also gonna take a look at Linux Mint very soon. But not on this laptop, because whatever I'm gonna install on this laptop is kind of permanent. It will stay for a long time. This previous Ubuntu that I had, the 17, was also on here for a pretty long time, more than 6 months. So yeah, but every so now and then I format the drives, and you know, I remove all information and I start all over again. So we don't deal with lots of machines that are having histories of many years. It's not good to have these things. In fact, every month or two, you should be able to do a clean install again and remove everything. This is the boot up screen, looks nice. I don't think I saw this in 17, I'm not even sure. We're gonna hit English. And English. Minimal installation, this will only install a minimal desktop environment with browser and utilities. No, I want third party installation, download updates while, no, we're gonna do that later. So this will only we can do a minimal installation, guys. That means that this will install a minimal desktop environment with browser and utilities. We could get all these other things ourselves. I think that is, I want minimal installation. Let's go for minimal installation. This is brand new. I never saw this before in Ubuntu, that we could do a minimal installation. Most of the times we would get all these big packages, such as these Office packages that come with Linux, the free ones. I never use them, always uninstall them, but I think for people that do these things, Office business is very nice. It's very lovely to have a device that can do, that have all these things installed. We're gonna do a real-time install, peeps. I'm gonna eat some nice roti with sardines. Oh my goodness, this is so fantastic. Are we still here? This is what I'm gonna eat, you see? So, because it's food time. And here we can say upgrade 17 to 18. Look at that. Look at that. So we can just do an upgrade. And then I will keep all my files, but I don't want that. I want to erase disk and install Ubuntu Mate. This is how to do, install. I'm not gonna do encrypt and all this crap. I'm not gonna do that. Amsterdam. This is lin48 password. Oops. So. Lin48. Log in automatically, it's just fine. And there you go, guys. So we're gonna install this, and of course, I'm not gonna let you look at the installer. Meanwhile, I'm gonna have my dinner really fast, and then I will be back as soon as this is empty. A quick glimpse of the installing. We see some nice things passing by that we did not see before. I think that the music app is also updated. We should not call it app, software. App sounds like so mobile. This is software. This is not app. Please don't you ever call Linux app. Rhythmbox updated, VLC being installed, amazing. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Who let the dogs out? Ooh, it was not me. You kick my dog, and now I'm gonna kill you. A little glimpse of some of the, I think, new wallpapers. I see some new wallpapers here that I, well, maybe I did see them before, but I cannot remember. Beautiful, look at that. What is that? That looks like a, wow, a mixture between a mule and some tapir or so. Crazy animal, see that? Baby art, oh, it's an aardvark, you stupid. Aardvark, of course. This is Ubuntu aardvark. Oh, you are not so smart today, Puck. You are disappointing me. And there we go. Everything you need to make your office. That is very nice because you can have free office thanks to Ubuntu, also Linux Mint and the other distributions, not to forget about them. Well, the reason why I'm going for Ubuntu is because Ubuntu, you know, Ubuntu, it looks great. Yeah, what can I say? It does collect some information about you, and once in a while it can suck a little bit that you put in some USB device and then, you know, it's not being detected, and then you must restart again to get it fixed. So also advised, if you're gonna use USB sticks, external drives and these things, phones that you're gonna use as, you know, external drive to get to the information, then you must not forget that whenever you're gonna remove the device, that you remove it carefully, that you remove it in a safe way, okay? Like remove USB stick, otherwise you might get a problem. Then the next time when you connect that device, it's not being detected, or it will copy files, and then when you go use the file is not working. It happened to me, copying to SD card. That was the screen that effect went to sleep. Because at this moment it's running a full, it's running the live version of USB Ubuntu over the USB. It's running the USB version, to say it this way. And this is also cool to know for those that don't really understand about Linux and, you know, saw this video and thought, hey, let's check it. Linux is also operating system that will let you use your laptop without a hard drive. So if there's no hard drive in the laptop, you can still use Ubuntu. You could literally run it from a CD, from a DVD in this case, because it's 1800 megabytes, so it's almost 2 gigabytes
the full ISO file. But in fact, you could run it straight from a USB stick or some whatever, and it would work just fine. You would be able to do everything. Well, everything. Certain things probably would not be possible, because then you need to install the system. Okay, so you could, for instance, not probably. Let me think. What could you not do? You can do many things, but certain things you will not be able to do. But at this point, I cannot even tell you what that is. You can go on the internet, you can download stuff, you can, you know, play music, play videos. That all will be possible. But certain things, you will not be able to do everything. Then you must install the system, okay? You can also install it to a USB stick. So that's also kind of possible with Linux. The coolest is that you will be able to bring that USB stick with you wherever you go. In fact, Android looks a whole lot like Linux. All the benefits we have with in Android world, we also have with Linux. That's because Android is Linux. Only a little bit different, but it is just Linux. It's just Linux, my friends. It's just Linux. And we're almost there. And then we're gonna reboot. And then this whole thing was installed. And the coolest of this is, my friends, it's completely free. It doesn't cost l'argent. If you want to give the guys something, it's up to you, you're free to do that. And I would, you know, like to ask you to do that. Give these guys €5, send them €10. You know, so they stay motivated, they will stay motivated. And in fact, these guys are also connected to Conexial, Conexial or so, whatever it's called. So there's lots of things going on the background that we don't know about. So you don't have to worry that Ubuntu will suddenly not be there anymore, just like certain Linux distros. These guys are working their, you can say, their balls off every day, just to get things going and to get it right. I love this company. Ubuntu is a very sweet company. Once I ordered CDs, was completely free. I think it was at version 8 years ago, somewhere, I think end 90s or so. But then we were not smart enough to use Linux. I always felt very lonely on Linux. At that time, you know, we had all these services like MSN and we didn't have Facebook at that time. But I felt kinda, and I don't even know why I felt lonely at that time on the system. Because not many things changed. You know, Ubuntu was the very first, and at that time we could not even appreciate it. Ubuntu was the very first that had their own app store. From all the operating systems you see, Linux was the first to have an app store. All the companies that came after that, these are all copycats. They all learned from Linux. So Linux is the god from all the operating systems. Really. It's, you can say, the god. And of course, Windows will not like when I say this. And Mac will also not like when I say this. And of course, they all have their specialties. Certain things that you do with the Mac, you cannot do with Linux. We're done.
then just restart, eh? Don't remove the stick yet. Wait for the stick. Wait until you get a Roger D that you can remove it. It's saying there on top, no catching mode, bloody bloody blah. No catching mode page found. Don't worry about it. And it's saying resuming drive catch right through. So now it's effect fixing grip and all these things, I think. Or maybe it already did that. But you should not remove the stick yet. It's still busy. Otherwise you're gonna skip certain files that need to be installed. And now you can see that you can safely remove the installation media. And hit enter, my friends. And there we go. Now you don't have to do anything. It will just boot straight up to La System. This will be the first time boot. It's detecting the screen now, setting the resolution right. You don't have to do that. Linux will do it for you. The black screen is a little bit scary. Don't worry about it. It's just a matter of booting up. This is how it boots. This looks kind of good. We're improving. And there we are, my lovely people. We're gonna be welcomed probably with a very beautiful background. Oh, it's the same one that we got whenever we started the installing. It looks fine. I love the green. So now the system is booted up. So let's see what we got. Applications. First thing that I'm gonna do, I'm gonna remove this. I remove the lock and then I say remove from panel. I'm also gonna remove this from panel. Okay, so now we're gonna go here with the mouse and then we're gonna say add to panel and we're gonna look for the mate menu. Here it is, the mate advanced menu. That's what you're gonna click. Okay, and now you say close. Oh yeah, in fact, let me see, I should also be able to, I think this is fine, this is just good, because now we have this and we can build from here. We can look what we have. Applications. So what do we have here? Sorceries. In internet we only have a browser. Office. Mate directory. And document viewer. Nice. Sound. No player, no nada. So system tools, etc., etc., etc. So we should also find software and update software boutique. We grab the icon and we could put it here somewhere on top. You see that there? And software and update, software updater. And this configure the sources. And you will find out that the Ubuntu App Store is not yet installed. So now we're gonna go ahead and start up the software boutique. So we can go ahead and start setting up the system. And here you will find the software boutique with the several sections. It's still booting. Okay. And if we go to the first section, you will find a sorceries that you could install if you wish. I don't see anything here that would really warm me up. Education, nothing like that. Games, no games. Graphics, let's see what we got here. Dia, projector, glipic, ink, blah, blah, blah. I don't see anything that I really need here. Internet. You might want to install Adobe Flash Player. Let's look a little bit further. Firefox already installed, very well. Beautiful. Google Earth, I don't need all that. Opera, I don't need that. Remina is nice to connect to other devices. Pigeon, I'm not gonna use that. Telegram, look at that. WhatsApp is not supported, but Telegram is supported. The Tor browser, Transmission, you might want to get Transmission, because when we download Linux distros, we find out that they rather have us downloading it with torrents. And we see UGET, lightweight, easy to use download manager. It provides the following features: resume downloads. I want it. UGET. Okay. So now we had the internet section. We go to the office. There's nothing there that I would really want. No programming stuff. Not really for me. I leave that to the pros. But I do want Audacity. Kazam, no. I do want Kodi. Pulse audio control. Simple screen recorder, of course we want it. Rhythm box, of course I need it. Spotify, also want it. I have a premium account. And VLC. How can we live without VLC? So these are the things that we now selected in video. We go to system tools, we look a little bit here. Brasero, I would install it. We'll let you write ISO files. Universal access, I don't need that as yet. Servers, I'm not really somebody that is into servers. More software, I would install this one as well. And provides the same features as the apt-get command utility. Synaptic package manager. Maybe we should also install that, I'm not sure. But I think this is fine. Fixes. Outdated package list, broken packages, configure, okay. This is whenever you're gonna have broken packages, etc. So here you can see that we're downloading. And we say apply changes. So now it's gonna download all the apps that we just selected. They are here in the list. And as soon as that is done, we can then immediately use these apps. I told you that I'm gonna make a pair laptop of this. So we also gonna do some theming, but I think we can better keep the theming for another video, otherwise this video will get way too long. I just in fact wanted to take a look at Ubuntu 18. I wanted to install it on this system, and we could also do an upgrade. So in fact the backup that I did was nice, but it was not really needed. Okay. The most beautiful part of this menu is that I can hit right mouse click, preferences, and change the start menu into everything I wish. So I can put a little pair up here. So when I'm gonna click this, the little pair, the menu will open. I can even up here you can see menu. I can remove that and I can say finder, and then audio, video, system. What can we put more? And help. Okay, so now you can see that here at the top, we got a little menu as just like in Apple. You see that? Only thing that we need to change now is, of course, the little. So we could easily go ahead and go to the internet. It's gonna boot up. It's doing several things at this time, so it will let us wait a little bit. Don't worry about it. And there we go. Nice blue page there of Firefox. Oh, very nice. You will find out that Google will not be set as a search engine up here. Let's go to the preferences. Okay, and up here we can set our start page, google.com. Okay, and this all is just fine. We go there again, we go to add-ons, and in add-ons, in extensions, you can add several things. Spotify failed to install. Installing packages. Probably I needed to put my password. Hey, but guys, this is it. Look at it. Beautiful. Look at it. Wow. And the coolest of this all is if you're gonna do some work, you can go ahead and change each and every icon in this system around. Right mouse click, edit properties. Yeah, here you click, oops, you click the icon, and you can browse for another icon that you wish to give it, you know, that looks good with your theme. However, we also have themes. And I think themes is under, let me see, appearance, I think it's under that. Yes, there it is. And we have the black, the dark black theme, but we also have this one, Black Mate. And I think this is a little bit too dark for me. We also have this one. These are all themes. We'll also give you a different start menu. You see that? I don't see that we really got different icons, but here everything got a little bit darker. And yeah, the icons, they all stay the same. So in fact, Linux Mint really did something with the themes that Ubuntu did not do. Ubuntu is using one icon pack for everything. What I saw until now. Maybe I'm wrong. And this is traditional green. This also looks nice. Oh no, this is not nice. I think this one is better. Ambient Mate. I think this looks good, huh? Black. And right mouse click here and preferences. Up here you see the theme. Okay, these are the colors of the theme. You also can change that in other colors, so you can make a combination of the theme with other colors. You can go here and you can check your settings. Icon size you can set here, you can set it to 40. Favorites you can set to 40. Places you can set to 34 or so, and this one as well, 31 or 2. And now, boom, you see that? The start menu just got bigger, and you can make it as big as you wish until it reaches until here. So that means you will have to play with the sizes of the icons. And then, oh, I saw something here. What did I see? I saw that we had a dock. Where is it? Where did I see it? Ah, there it is, plank, look at that. So you can make a sort of Mac from this thing. Not that I want plank, because I don't really need plank. But how to turn off plank? Right mouse click. Here maybe. Gosh, I don't want plank. Close. I cannot close plank. Menu preferences. Well, I just put plank and now I don't know. Oh, maybe this is plank here. Ubuntu made bottom center. Oh, you can also alignment. This is to put it in the center. This is, how about height? Icon size, you can make it bigger. Fill, what is this? You can put it at the top or at the side. Oh, look at that. You can also set it at the side. Hey, this is nice for my pear concept. I think I'm gonna keep this. I'm gonna keep this, but will it not be annoying? If I open a page, will it go over the page? It will close, but it will come all the time. I'm not sure. I'm not sure if I'm gonna keep this, man. Quit. Go away. YouTube. Okay, we quitted it. You see just the icon and then you can quit it. Now, we do have internet because I have a cable connected, but if you go to additional drivers, if you have no internet, it's very wise to have an internet cable connected to the laptop. It is connected to your router for the first time. If your Wi-Fi is not being, you know, found, if you're gonna start up the Ubuntu and you're gonna try here, you see broadcam, it said it found the wireless card in use, so that's lovely. So that means if I remove the cable, we could say enable Wi-Fi. The Wi-Fi is disabled. So let's see if we can enable it. Hey, I just had to turn it on the thing. So I can remove the cable now and I can connect to my Wi-Fi.
Well, my friends, it was a very, very long video again. I hope you enjoyed it. I enjoyed making it. This was in effect the installing of Ubuntu 18 Lite, because this is the first time that I saw an installer in Ubuntu that we could choose to install a minimalistic version of Ubuntu. So that is really great. Many apps were not installed. As you could see, we added them really easy thanks to the software boutique. We also added the other store, so we will have two stores, one store that will have all the rest that you won't find in boutique. Kodi working out of the box, you can watch live TV. So I think this is a fantastic operating system. It's completely free, so if you have some buck to spare, please go to the Ubuntu website and donate them. and let them know that you also appreciate them working on this all. So I want to thank Ubuntu, especially Ubuntu, the developers, for making this beautiful version. Thank you for the new installer that will let us do a minimalistic install. I find it really cool. So this will be called Ubuntu 18 Lite. It's the pre-release, so have some mercy on it if it's here and there not doing exactly what you want it to do. But it will get better, of course, as soon as the rest is done. So thank you all for watching. If you think this video was helpful, of course, leave it a like. If you enjoyed this all what you saw, subscribe to my channel so you will see more. But to see more of my channel, subscribing is not enough. The word subscription here on YouTube has different meaning. A subscription means that once in a while, probably never ever again, you will hear from me. And the little bell that you see, that was brought 1.5 years ago, that one you will have to click and you will have to confirm. So in fact, 3 clicks you will have to do, and then confirm that you would like to see even more videos that I create whenever I upload them. So yeah, then you will be updated. So that's the meaning of this subscription button here on YouTube. It goes together with the bell. Don't ever forget it. Thank you again for watching, and I love to see you in the next video again. That will be about the pimping to the iPair system, the iPair desktop. We're gonna change the boot animation, of course, change the look and feels, and see what we can do about certain icons. Until then.